And even then, I was fired up again. I was locked in and focused, but I didn't have the Sweetpea look just yet. So he wanted me to hang out with, shout out again to Big Cat. And Big Cat said, look, man, I've been watching you do your thing. You got the look. You look the part. But all that yelling and shit, that ain't it. You know what I mean? And then John was like, yeah, no, he's right. What you got to do is you got to internalize all that shit. So learn it. It's kind of like in Rocky III when Rocky loses and then Apollo takes him to his gym and he says, see that look? You got to get the eye of the tiger. And I'll never forget, he really, you know, he took me, sorry, we going to your hood. I'll never forget, right? He said, look, I'm going to take you to my hood, meet some of my dudes. Now, I got your back, but if some shit go down, don't be no weenie. And I was like, nah. Like, I almost wanted to start some shit to prove that this is just like going. I remember we went to like City Walk or something. I'd be looking like, I wish somebody would. We went to his hood. This is his hood. He's a gangbanger. I don't shit him. Yes, sir. But I'm doing like he said. I'm just paying attention. Shut the fuck up. Playing my, you know, as people, you cool. They're humans. You know what I'm saying? But if you come on there tripping, that's your ass. You know what I'm saying? So I knew I was with him. I was cool. And we never got into nothing. There's no stories about that. But I think from the time of soaking it up with him, and then the chip on my shoulder, the other chip that I had was people would come on set like, oh, man, I hear you playing Sweetpea. Good luck. And then I go, all right, I can't wait till he say action, you know. And that kind of locked me in. And then when we were filming, the first scene we filmed was the garage scene where I tell, where my character tells Tyrese's character that he wants to be saved. And if you watch the scene, he's already intense. I mean, for most of the movie, he's always intense. But John Singleton was like, look, man, this is the scene I'm sending to Paramount. Like, this is it. We're just getting started here. They got to see this and go, yep, you got a movie. Let's keep going. Here's some more money. I need you jumping up and down, do some push-ups, some jumping jacks, whatever. I want your heart beating out your chest before I say action. So that's what I did. And I remember, I to this day, before I get ready to do a raw, I'll get down and do some hubba. So I'm about to just, they say action. I'm almost out of breath. You know what I mean? But the look was there. The mindset was there. And once we got through with that scene, the rest of the movie, in my opinion, was easy as far as, you know what I mean? That was the toughest part, was just getting the look now.
Now, was that the scene we talked about how you leave the house at 9 and come back at 6 and pretend like you're doing something?
Absolutely.
Can you reenact that somewhat? Because I just really love that scene.
No, but.
Oh, well, I tried. I tried.
No, I mean, it's just. The thing is,
it was just so poignant, you know what I mean? Because really, as a man, you could, you know, like, wow, like, so you're living here with this woman who's basically, her and her mother is taking care of you.
Yeah.
So you leave the house at 9 to pretend to go to work.
Yeah.
And come home at 6 while you're basically doing nothing all day.
Yeah.
Pretending like you just did something.
Yeah.
Knowing you didn't do nothing. You have no money in your pocket. Yeah. You got to depend on a woman when you're a man. It's just, you know, it's a crushing kind of feeling, you know?
It all is hats off to John Singleton, man. Now, when I talked about the rehearsing, jumping around and the cut and all that, that was our time to improv. After that, it was, here's the script. Stick to the script.
Word by word.
Word by word. That's how John was. When it says written by John Singleton, it's written. Not written by John and improvs a little bit. Nah. You had your chance to get all your little extras, you know, in the rehearsals. But when it's locked in, it was locked in. So all of those words, man, it was, you know, you read it and then you give it to him. And if he likes it, bam. If he doesn't, he'll tell you, do this, do that, or step the fuck up, you know. And yeah, it's best motivator ever.